I serve children who don't have a lot. I serve children who've been underserved for years. Blended learning opens doors to children in the sense of giving them individualized learning.
Having smaller groups helps heighten my presence for the kids one-on-one.
It pushes teachers to engage them in a different way.
At first I was thinking the same fears of like, oh no, like are they able to do this on their own? Technology, is that gonna be a problem? But from day one, I think the G8 math kids responded pretty positively and they appreciate it more because I think the control they feel.
I think I'm learning better this way because it gives me self-independence. So it gives me control of my own grade.
Meet children where they are. And when you're dealing with children in poverty who come with enormous amount of instructional and academic gaps, there's not enough hours in the day, frankly, to truly fill all the gaps. And the beauty of blended learning, it helps the teacher help fill in those gaps for the kiddos.
I actually used to hate math, but now I'm pretty good at it because of these videos and all this, like you know, because I'm getting used to math now, so I was mad I couldn't do it.
You would get frustrated.
We developed grit.
You've developed some grit, huh?
This is a better way for me to learn because I can actually rewatch things that I didn't understand.
The cool thing that we do is like pull out kids for coaching sessions, right? We've been very intentional and purposeful about that, and I think that's made a difference for kids to just reflect on who they are as a person and be like, hey, how does that connect to your learning? And think just even like having conversations about learning experiences, I think that's very new for them.
I remember in my years at KIPP, I remember they changed it from two college to two and through. And that was because students are getting to college but not getting all the way through. And no, I think the agency piece is a big part of that. It was actually one day this past week when a student got really frustrated and he was like kind of like almost at the point of like giving up. And then I told the students in that reflection, I said, this may seem challenging now, but there's a reason and why behind it. Because if it's challenging now, I'm trying to make sure you experience that now as a middle schooler when it's like a safer net for you. That when you get to high school and college, it just makes it much easier.
I really do look at blended learning as an opportunity to level the playing field, bring some equality through the classroom, and engage our babies in a different way so they find some ownership in their learning.